So without wasting any further time, let me show you how to use particle gen. So if you have downloaded it from Steam and installed it, then you can open it and it may look something like this, right? So let's first start small. Let us first export a sequence of images. The thing about particle gen is that you have a library of effects which you can access by clicking here, right? I already have some effect made. Let me delete it. Do you sure? Yeah, I'm sure. Then in this project window, you can see a user box, but you need to go to the library, which is L, which is here, library. Double click on it and you can see so many effects. If you click on one of them, big laser, but you cannot preview it right now. You want to preview it, right? To preview it, you have to open this preview window. So you can see the preview here. I mean, there are two frames here. One is a small frame, then one is a larger frame. So when you will you are just previewing the effect right now. When you will include this effect in your project, then it will come in this big window. But you don't have to worry about it right now. You can preview all these effects from here, all the effects, and you can use all the effects which are present here in your game without any restrictions. Let's see some magic effects. And there you go. And let me tell you that you can also change the colors in the effects. So let us try to do, let us make this effect smoke, magic cloud smoke. So you know, if you want to include this effect in your project, like if you want to start working on it, you must right click and copy. After copying, you must go to the user tab, which is labeled as you. And then you right click on user and paste, and there you go, your effect has come in the main window, the bigger frame. And now you just click on it and let us try to change the colors of the particles. So in order to change the colors, you can go to the P tab, which is mentioned here, P9 and P. Let us, after selecting any one of them, suppose I select P9. Now let me open this particle curves. In particle curves, you can see some colors. If you change this to here, see it turned green. I mean, I reduced the red component from its pin from the P9 particle, so it turned green. And similarly, if you decrease green a little bit, if you decrease green, it will turn something else. See, it turned pink, right? And this is like, you know, the timeline. I mean, the percentage of colors depends on this. You can also just play around with it and see what works for you, right? Like I. Really not sure why it is a graph, but yeah, just you can just play around, right? So let me close it, and then you can go for P particle and open the particle emitter curve, and there are lots of color lines. Just play around with the few of them and see what works for you. And look, it has become something like really weird colors, blue and pink fireball. Right, you can also change emitters. You can go to E tab and select one emitter and click on the emitter button, and here you can also do, but you can't see any lines here. There aren't any color lines because these are emitters, right? Yeah, so this is our let us just export this and see how it turns out to be. to export this effect. And one more thing, you can decide the resolution, right? So like the resolution will be this much only if you export it like this. So just make it closer so that it's good for us. You can change the resolution of the preview from here. Options, from options. You can change the window size from here, 1280, 720, and you can change it to anything. You can change it to 1920 cross 1080, till there, right? And that's it. You can change the FPS also, but I will keep it at 1280 to 720 only for this tutorial. So now let us export it. To export it, you have to go to preview and export to AVI / other file. So it exports only in TGA, DDS sequence or AVI file. For game design, it's best that you go for one of these. I will go for DDS. So you should always export all the frames so that you don't miss any one of them, right? There are 300 frames. Just click on all. 30 FPS, 1280 x 720, custom size. You also choose where you have to output it, then choose the base name. I will choose it to be Smoke Magic. Smoke Magic, I will put the name, and then right RGB channel we want, yes, alpha channel also, and then export. So it is now exporting 300 frames. We will wait for it, and then we will see if the frames have been, you will not be able to see right away because it is DDS format. You will have to convert them to PNG. It's very easy. Let me tell you how to do it. You need to have XnConvert installed in your computer to convert them. XnConvert is free. So now it has converted. Now you can minimize this. And now if you go to your directory where you have exported it, you can see the files. We exported it in document, particle gen, export. Yeah, so here we have it somewhere, must be having it somewhere. Let me see. I have made a lot of effects, so that's why there are so many of them. I had to make it for my game. Can't find it anywhere. Smoke Magic, yeah, DDS files. So I have got the Smoke Magic files. Now let me go to XnConvert and convert them to PNG. So this is XnConvert. You can just shift select all the files and paste it, drag them to XnConvert, right? So just drag these 301 files. It's 301 because it started from zero. So yeah, it looks good. Let us now go to, you remove any actions if you have, because you don't want to scale it or do anything else, right? So just go here, put it on source folder only, and you can delete original. You must always delete original in this case while you are working with effects, and then convert. So it's converting all the 301 files, so it's gonna take a while to convert, and so we will wait. I will cut this part. So it's it took a while, and it's going to be complete, and we will see how our effect turned out to be. So it's completed. and yeah, there it is. So let me just click on one of them, open one of them. Yeah, the first one, and you will see if there is any problem in the effect or there are unwanted artifacts if you don't want, right? We want our effects to be perfect, I mean, as like the way we want, the way we previewed them. So let me just try to run like this. Yeah, so it's so far. Wait, yeah, okay, it looks good. There is a transparent background, right? So it looks good so far to me. And when you will put it in front of your if you put it in your game, there will be a background and it will look even better, right? So there you have your effect sequence of images in PNG format, and you can use them in like your game or any video which you are making. So I will make more tutorials on this. I really don't know what emitter does at this point, but you can play with it because you can't see anything here. Whatever is grayed out is not available, I'm pretty sure. But here, oh yeah, there this line, let me see what happens. So like something must happen, right? But just play around with it. Nothing will go wrong, right? Just play around with all these curves and see for yourself what you can make. And there are the library is really huge. I mean, there are lots of effects. I think you can mix two effects. So next time I will try to mix two effects and show you how it turns out to be. Thank you for your time.